So I just finished sifting 1 cup of almond meal, and all of this extra chunks I'm gonna throw out.
So before you measure, whisk your powdered sugar, give it a little whisk so you get a better accurate measurement, and just measure 2 cups of powdered sugar and sift that and get rid of all those little lumps, okay? I'm gonna whisk the almond meal and the sugar, okay?
Make sure you whisk it really well.
Okay, so I have 3 egg whites, room temperature, and they foamed already, see? And now I'm gonna add 1/4 cup of sugar, granulated sugar. Eggs are ready, and they're pretty stiff, see?
That's it.
Okay. Trina is pouring the almond flour and the sugar, and gently folding this. And I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. So Ignacia added some green, and Katrina's gonna make yellow. And I just let a little bit, maybe less than 1/4 teaspoon of green. Oh, you wanna add a little bit more.
This is the green.
Oh no, because you might overmix.
The yellow.
So let's just add. This should be enough for your whole batch. What?
Katrina's worried about her dress.
It does not come off, so careful using it. And mine's pretty light. Katrina,
I'm already. I want to do it.
This is pretty crucial. We're folding it.
Oh, so we're. Again?
Yeah. Again, the crucial part. But this is what you want your batter to be. You want some movement.
And it should be that green.
Yeah, it should be green. But you know what? You can also color your egg whites, and that would be easier. And it will prevent over mixing. You know what, Katrina's? There. Mm-hmm. And see? And that's your perfect macaron batter. Okay? Now we'll keep putting the
batter on. I add a little bit of batter to my tray and put it on my parchment paper. And make sure you buy parchment paper. You don't need those silk caps. So my parchment paper doesn't lift while it's baking. And I'm gonna do little eggs before I add it with that. So this is what I'm gonna make my egg. I'm gonna add a little bit of batter. See, my batter is a little loose, but I think since we're making eggs, it's gonna work. And I'm just moving it this way. And to get rid of that tip that you sometimes see on the cones, just wiggle your tip. So I'm going to start on the top and then move to the bottom and squeeze more batter out. Gently keep on squeezing. Get rid of that tip. So I'm going to make it an egg macaron. Start from the top, move to the bottom, keep squeezing. See? And you have your egg. We're making green eggs, and we're also going to make chicklets. Katrina found them online. Oh, Pinterest. I need to start going on there. We'll die. There we go. Okay. Make our little chicklets. And just keep pressing until you get like a silver dollar. And this is the easiest way. And just apply equal pressure, and when you're finished, to get rid of that tip, just wiggle your tip. And these are easier than oval shaped eggies. Okay, so our shells are dry, and it was like actually more than 50 minutes. It was 20 minutes. I'm gonna pop in the oven at 300 degrees for 17 minutes. You can either go from 15 to 20, depends on your oven temperature. I heard that electronic ovens take longer. This is a gas one, and it's pretty accurate, so we're gonna do for 15 seconds. Okay? Okay, so make the circle, and then add 2 bunny ears. And I can apply equal pressure, and start from the top, move towards the bottom, and just get rid of all that. Okay? And this is a pretty condensed video. If you want a more detailed macaron making video, watch my other ones, subscribe too, okay? Unsalted, room temperature, and I'm gonna add 3 cups of powdered sugar. For this one, we're gonna add 3 cups and 1/4 cup of lime juice, and that's gonna make our lime macarons. Okay, thanks. And the macarons are done. It's been 15 minutes. Oh my. my god, how cute these are! And then they're gonna be super cute.
I can't wait to them.
Decorate them, see? So what I did was added some frosting, some little buttercream, and then I just added the sprinkles on top. Can you get closer? Okay. I'm gonna add the sprinkles. Cut them down. Oh, you get the point. They come out prettier. You can put more time into them. And I think this is better than decorating eggs that you're not gonna even eat. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna make a little chicken. I'm gonna put a little bit of frosting. I'm gonna grab some. These are like snowflake sprinkles that I got them for Christmas. And I'm gonna add maybe 4 or 3. There you go. And I'm gonna add heart. I bought these for Valentine's and a little cuckoo about holidays. Add it to the heart itself. This is gonna be I'm gonna have these edible markers from Moulton. I'm gonna draw the eyes. Oh, and there's your little pollito. Pew pew pew. Isn't that cute? Super cute. Okay, so for Halloween we found these eyes and Katrina and I drew these little lashes and eyeshadow. So I'm gonna glue them to our bunny. It's cute. And I put a little frosting in the back. Be gentle because my friends are very gentle. Where's the one with the frosting? And then a sprinkle for the nose. And then I'm gonna draw. Isn't that so cute? I hope you like it. Oh wait, I'm gonna draw the back. And I'm gonna add actually 4 little sprinkles in the back. Because a little puffy cap. I'll show you later. Okay. See? Little bunny. With a little bunny doll. And try to subscribe and like Mommy's the Chef on Facebook. Hopefully you enjoy. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.